Please subscribe to UiPath Expo Hub channel and hit the bell icon. Be the first person to watch the latest automation videos. Hello friends. Today we are going to learn UiPath VB.NET date format specifiers. So this is required. You need to understand how the date format specifiers are available, how you can change one date format to different date format. So this will take few minutes of your time. Please watch the video completely so that you will make a note of all of these things and you will remember for lifetime. Myself Rakesh from UiPath Expo Hub. So let's get started with today's topic. Please do subscribe to our channel. Please do like all the videos that you're watching. Thanks. So let's get started. So for that, to demonstrate this, what are the different date format specifiers are there, right, in UiPath VB.NET. So I have taken today's date, okay. I am taking an assign activity, input date format. Input date format is my variable and it is a string type, okay. And now the second one, I am taking another assign activity, defining another variable called output date format, and here I am going to write the code. So that means this is your input and you have to convert it to some other format, okay. So now you need to highlight couple of things, okay. First is, this is string, this is not a date to time. So first of all, let me convert it to date time, okay. So how do you convert the string to date time? For that, the simple expression that you have to write is convert. Let me show you. So you're writing convert dot, okay, to date time, okay. That's all you need to remember. And in the bracket you have to mention the exact your input string. So your variable is input date format, right? So you have to mention the variable input date format, okay. And then you are done. So that way it is going to convert whatever string format into date format, convert to date time. That's all you need to remember, okay. So this is the very first step. Now here it's giving error, reason being you have to go to variable and here I need to convert this to date time. For that, what you do, click on browse for types and here you need to type system dot date time, okay. This is the namespace that you have to use from VB.NET. Okay, so I'm using the namespace. Click on OK. So now the data type has been selected. Okay, all right. So now what happened? Let me see the output. So you see there is a hyphen like this, right? Now if I convert it by default, how it comes, let me have a check. So let me run it. Okay, boom. So you see that 8/25/2020. Clear. And it is also putting the time format, but there is no time, so it is 0000. Okay, now this is where your question would come. So I am completely dealing with date format, as I said in the beginning, only date format. I am not dealing with time now. So for the date format, what I want, see, my hyphen has been replaced with the forward slashes, right? Everything has changed. Now I want to show you how you can apply different things, okay. So for that, again go to the value and here let me write it. So how you have to write, everything remains the same, okay. So once you convert, what I want, I wanted to hit on dot and simply write date, okay. So by writing date, I have an option to change the date. So when I write dot date and try to run it again, you will see the same value, no change. Okay, just concentrate now. So 8/25/2020, it is again giving the same value, but with this expression I can change it. For example, I want to change this something like this. I do not want the month at the beginning, I want the date. So I want something like date, then I want a hyphen, I don't want that forward slash, and I want that month, and then I want the year, right? This is how I want. Now for this, what I'm going to do, very simple. Now you'll ask me, you have already taught in the previous video, why you are teaching this now? I'm going to show you so many things, okay. So here, convert to date time, input date time dot. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to convert this to string again so that I can change to different format, to string, okay. And here, all right, to string. Now here what I'm going to do, I am going to literally write what format I want, okay. And what are that date format specifiers you need to know? For example, in the bracket, okay, in double quotes. This is the syntax. Here I want date. So for the date I am doing DD. Okay, then I want a hyphen. Then for the month I am doing capital MMM. Then for the year I am doing small YYY. Now you will ask me why it is small, why it is capital. Yeah, exactly. That is the thing I am going to teach you in this UiPath VB.NET date format specifiers. You have to understand that. Okay, so let me first demonstrate how the output comes. So what is happening here, it is showing the error because it is in date format, the variable. So I am converting that to string. So here what I am going to do, I will put it back to string. Okay, so that way my error will be resolved, and let me run it. So try this out. When I'm teaching, you can always open UiPath and try all of this. So you can see now exact format 25 August 2020 has come the way I want. Okay, now I want to specifically concentrate on the date. Okay, only the date in the sense your 01/02/03, today is 25th of August, so 25th. So here, how do you write this? So the date is actually written in lowercase, remember. You cannot use a uppercase. Uppercase will give you a wrong data. So lowercase you have to use. What is that? You can use single D, okay, or you can use double D, you can use triple D, you can use 4D. Have you seen this? Single D, double D, what are these things? Single D, why the double D, how I can write? Okay, let me show you this. So what is single D? For example, let's say my date is 01. Okay, now if I run this, what is happening? By default, it is showing me 01 August 2020, right? It will show me the output. So it is showing 01. So I don't want the 0. I want only 1. So how do I get it? Okay, and I'm going to also show you how do you get Monday, Tuesday and all that, right? So let me show you. So now here, if I write instead of double D, if I'm writing single D, it will emit that 0. And if it is a single digit number, it will simply show me 1. So that is the use of single D. Now if I write double D, it will give 01. You understood. Now what is the meaning of triple D? So if I write triple D, even there is a format date format specifier, which is triple D. So if I write triple D, what happens? So this is going to show you the date. So 01/01/2020 fallen on which date? So 01 fallen on Saturday. So let me run this. If I'm writing triple D. So when I run this, you will see it is saying Saturday, August. Then you will ask me, Rakesh, I don't want Saturday, August. I want Saturday, 01 August. Okay. So how to write that? Very simple. Again, go here. And you want to do Saturday, right? Saturday, then you want 01 or 0, up to you. So if I want 01, then DD, MMM, YYY. If I write this and click on OK, and okay, let me show you. Okay, I'm becoming slightly quick. Let me show you how I have written DDD slash DD slash MMM slash YYY. Okay, so Saturday, 01 August 20. This is how it will come. Okay, so let me run this. So the output is Saturday, August. So you will say, no, Rakesh, I don't want SAT. I want Saturday, the entire spelling. Okay. Now for the entire spelling, what you do again, very simple. Go back and here, instead of writing a triple D, what I'm going to do, I'll put 4D. If I use 4D as a date format specifier, it is going to show me Saturday. So you will see that now. Okay, so it's showing Saturday, 01 August 2020. So you have understood how to use this four different formats, you know, depending on your need. Okay, this one I have shown you. Then let me show you also month. So month is always written in capital letter, remember that. Okay, uppercase or capital letter. Now if it is written in uppercase, the format can be M, it can be double M, it can be triple M, it can be 4M. Okay, now what are all this? Let me quickly show you. I don't have to go in detail, but let me quickly show you. So let me keep this one as it is, and here let's say I'm using single M. So if it is single M, again the month is, let's say 08, then it will say 8. Okay, if it is double M, then it will say 08. If it is triple M, it is going to show me, again in capital, it is going to show me August, AUG. Now what is 4M? When I say 4M, let's run this. So it is going to give the complete month name. Instead of AUG, it will say AUGUST, August. So you can see that This is what the month format stands for. Understood? And very useful, guys. Very, very useful. You should know all of this. Now, the next is year. Now, year has to be written in lowercase. Remember that. Lowercase. And this has to be Y. It can be double Y. It can be even triple Y. It can be even 4Y. It can even be 5Y. Okay. Now, you will ask me why I... So, let's see that. Okay. If I write single Y, what happens? Let's see that. So, in here, I am going to write single Y. So, what I am going to do? Here, instead of 4Y, I know 4Y means 2020, it will show me. So, I want single Y. So, single Y, how it shows? Let me see. So, let me run it. So, these are the different date format specifiers. So, it's saying 20. Okay. Let's say the year is 2001 or something like that. So, it would have shown me 1. So, it is Y. So, it will, if there is an 0 ahead of that, it will remove. Okay. And then if I am writing YY, again it will show the same value. What if I write triple Y? How it is showing? Let me see. So 020 it will show me. Okay, 2020 will be shown as 020. Now it is showing me, sorry, triple Y, sorry. Triple Y stands for the complete year. Like triple D, right? Triple D, triple M stands for AUG. So triple Y stands for complete year. Now you will ask me, then what is the difference? Why we have 4Y? So if I write 4Y and click on run, okay, it is also showing me 2020. So what is the difference between 4Y and because you see, when you are writing 4M, it is converting that to full month. I mean, it will write August. So for year, it is nothing like that. So either you can choose to go with triple Y or you can choose to go with 4Y. Okay. So it is not going to say 020, rather it is going to show. So you can think the year is 00111, right? If you are in that year. So that is where it is going to help you. But otherwise, you can simply go with 4Y. Okay, so there is no way of writing single Y, but depending on your, but I have seen general need is 4Y or 2Y. 2Y is like 20, 30, 21, like that is also good enough. So these are the two different formats that you will be mostly using. Now there is also a triple Y. So sorry, 5Ys. Why 5Ys? Let's say we are going ahead of that year. Let's say we are reaching 20201. Right, sometime in the future. So it's a futuristic way. If you are writing that, what will happen is, I think it's going to add one more extra zero to it, that's all. But again, at this era, I think this is not of so much of use. So when we go, I don't know how many 100 200 years ahead, that's where probably it will be more useful. Okay, so that is a futuristic way. So these are the, so all I wanted to, my goal was to ensure you know that there are different format specifier. I wanted to tell you about complete UiPath VV.NET date format specifiers. Okay, that was my goal. So once you know all the specifiers, I think it will be easy for you to utilize. And how you want, somebody wants, let's say somebody wants the date to be at the beginning. So all of this, you just have to change the place. Why year at the start, M at the beginning. So just replace this things, right? That's where you will get the entire thing. So I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope there's a good learning that you have got on this one. So I'm going to come up with a lot of VV.NET codes which will help you in the future. All right. Thank you guys for watching. Please do subscribe as I request. Please do like. I always request my viewers, please do like the videos. That helps the channel. Thank you very much for all your support. You guys have a wonderful day.